down at the barn.
Of course.
Just cleaning up where Dolly sleeps, because it's a mess. Not only would I not want to sleep in just such a nasty place as this, it's nasty this morning. Cleaning a stall is actually one of the best ways that you can prevent mastitis in the cows. Plus, a dirty stall like this makes milking so messy because she comes out there with an udder that's just caked with manure.
So do any of you know how many pounds of manure a cow will drop in a year? If you know, leave a comment below before the end of the video. I'll tell you at the end of the video and see if you can guess. But you gotta leave the comment before you get to the end of the video. This really smells bad.
Time for round two.
You might look at that stall and say, oh, we're neglecting it, but we actually either put hay or straw down or clean out the cow pies every day pretty much. And it still gets really dirty really fast. I'm dumping all this manure into this little area down by the barn. This is kind of an auxiliary garden. It's just a mini little garden down here. I think I may turn this into a berry patch. It's already got some raspberries along the side behind me here. And my idea is to actually fence the pigs in here and let them just tear this area up and work all this manure in. But I haven't figured out how to move pigs yet.
A bale of straw. Always get the baling twine out of the way because animals, especially curious ones like goats, can easily get tangled in especially a loop of baling twine.
I milked Dolly this morning. It went really well. I was getting where I could use both hands, and that nice squirt, squirt, squirt in the bucket. Got about 2 gallons. A little bit of it got poop in it because she pooped on the stand. And so that last bit I took out, gave it to the pigs, and they slurped it right down. We remembered, or rather learned, this trick of how to teach your cow not to poop on the stand. And what you do is you take a bucket or a shovel, and as soon as they start pooping, you hold the bucket right up underneath their behind and you catch the poop and they stop. They don't like that. They're like, what is going on? They don't hear the splat on the ground. Whatever it is, they don't like pooping in a bucket. I mean, who likes pooping in a bucket? But they don't like it.
You know, the thing that gets me is that there were actually pretty clean areas in this stall that she could have laid in last night, but it seems like she chooses to lay down in the dirty areas. And that kind of leads me to the next point, which is, we've been reading a lot and thinking a lot about this, and I think that Dolly is kind of just a dirty cow. And they say that some cows are more fastidious in where they'll lay down and where they'll poop, and other cows just don't seem to care. And I don't really think Dolly cares that much. I guess we should give her some credit. She is 9 years old, and her udder, well, her udder's clean now because I scrubbed it. I scrubbed her udder with probably 15 rags. Usually I use 6 and get it real nice and clean. Dolly, even if you're a dirty girl, we still love you. Still love you a lot. You're a great cow. She's just been so good for us. She's very, very sweet. Completely non-aggressive. She's never tried to kick anyone. Never tried to charge anyone or shove anyone. So she's a good family cow. and given us and just an amazing richness in milk. I don't think we could have a vlog in the barnyard without this guy being featured. Get out of the way, she says. You can hear the water going down her throat.
And I think the best solution for keeping your cow clean is to have it out in pasture all the time. Right now, while the weather's really cold, and partially because of the new calf, we're keeping the cow in the barn.
The other reason that we keep her in the barn is she's not 100% happy with getting in that milk stand every morning. She's doing better and better every morning, but we're afraid that if we let her out in the pasture, it'll just be more stressful on her and more of a challenge to get her into the barn and into the milking stand. We know that once she's just used to milking again, that she'll go straight in.
Consider yourself updated on the pigs. They're just out there happy as ever, eating and munching and rooting and, of course, grunting. Guess what happens when you leave a gate open in the barn? Goats are out. I will not be tempted to chase the goats in an undignified manner. Come on, let's go. Oh, come on, come on. Where one goat, another one. Where one goat goes, the rest will follow. We're also making a strong effort to clean our milking process in other ways. I'm gonna cut some footage from the other day where I was cleaning this room out and getting ready to put the milking stand in here. We've been milking kind of in a dirty area. We've been milking out here where the animals come when it's raining, just like now. So we're gonna use this room. There's all kinds of junk in here. You know, we had friends who had a wedding out here a while back, and they were awesome, but they had guys come out and just shifted a lot of stuff down here.
Get back in there. Get back in there. Come on.
Now I can just leave this door open so some of this stuff can get stored in this empty stall. Hey, puppy dogs, in out of the rain. Got this beautiful old country table straight from the pages of Country Living, except this one's a real country table. Goats are hilarious. Hello, how are you doing, Moonbeam? Oh wait, you're Raven, sorry. Now I've got to get this huge stairway out of here. There's no room with the stairway in here for Dolly to get in the milking stand and get out and turn around. So it's gotta go. We don't really use it anyway. I'm gonna try to take it out in one piece so I can use it somewhere else in the future. Well, that's not gonna work. Not to leave you hanging, but Bree asked me to come back up to the house for a little bit, at least a little bit, if not for the rest of the day. So I'm gonna let these animals out and head up to the house for a few minutes. To finish the milking room project, we've really just got three more things to do. Each of them are fairly big jobs. One, I've gotta finish getting the stairwell out of there. Two, I need to move the milking stanchion into that room. And the funny thing is, some of you are gonna think this is really funny. The milking stanchion is way too big to fit through the door, so I have to partially disassemble it, put it on its side, and then it will slip in, and I think it will stand up. And then the last thing is I need to get a load of wood chips, put them on the floor. Well, this has been another great day on the homestead, and
We always appreciate y'all watching and supporting us. We'll see y'all in our next video as the saga continues.